Hello everyone, my name is Chisom. I'm from Nigeria. As an undergraduate student, I studied chemistry at the University of Nigeria. And after my undergraduate degree, I wanted to further my education, but I also love adventure. I wanted to, you know, go out there and see what education is like in other parts of the world. It is very competitive to get a spot to do your PhD in the US with just a bachelor's degree. So that's why I decided to go to Europe to do my master's. I started my journey in France, and then I did a semester in Poland and also in Italy. It was a very rewarding experience. You know, I got to experience European cultures, food, and a lot of awesome things. And I think that really helped me a lot, because having an international degree, apart from what I had in my country, kind of made me stand out during my application. So while I was still doing my master's, I checked out a couple of schools in the US, and then I applied for my PhD, and I got into the University of California in Davis. I got to hear about the Duolingo English Test when I was applying for my PhD, and I decided to check it out. It cost about $49, and it only took me about 45 minutes to complete, and that was awesome compared to the grueling, gruesome 4 hours I had to face while writing TOEFL or IELTS. So I applied for that. I got a great score at the first trial, and then I used that to submit my applications. At first, I thought it was going to be easy peasy. And when I took the actual test, I found that the more easily I answered the questions, the harder it got. If you're able to get a good grade in the Duolingo English test, you'd be able to stay in a classroom, understand the lecture. Being able to understand and communicate basic English, it's one of the things you need to, you know, be in a classroom. And I think the test actually does a great job at testing that. If you're gonna be seeing me watching this video, I mean, my advice to you is go for that shot. Stop saying next year, stop saying, oh, I'm applying, start now, and just, you know, you can never find out if you're good enough until you try. So yeah, stop holding yourself back.